Hi, and welcome back to our open Stopmotion film project. Today, or yesterday, and the day before, we made a lot of trees, as you can see here. And there are even more to come, but that's what we're doing. But without leaves, they don't look right. So here, we need to make leaves like that. And to do that, this is a big one with a big tree, but it's easier to see. I have a bundle of threads, you can see here, and like this. Oops. There is 19 thread in the way I do them in a bunch, and they are put together in the bottom here, and then I separate them out, 3 to this side and 3 to this side, and then I take them out in individual threads. And this up here, I make 5 to each size, and 2 out here and 3 in the outer. And up here, I make made 3 go through, and then I separate them out. So, and then you get something that looks like a branch with leaves on. So that's how I do them. And but first, as you can see, there is lots of trees, and on the tree we have here, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 let me see how many there are. 4, 5, 6 Yeah. And I even want maybe one more here on the other side or something. So from each, for each of those three you see here, we have to have at least at least on the fill trees, and this tree is a fill tree, you know, these very simple trees I have made. But as you can see here, there is a lot of there are some trees that are more complicated than that, and there we have to put even more leaves on. But on the fill trees, and those are the ones we are beginning with. So, and to those we have to make 6 or 7, 8 to each tree. So, and you can see there is a lot of them down there. So, and there's I have 700 when I get the last one tea. And then you can time that with 6. So we need to make a lot of those. So first we need to make these bundles of 19 strings, threads, and I have one extra here. And what I do is I stretch when they are coiled up on a spool like this, then they are, you can see they are kind of, can you see, they are kind of, they are they're not straight. So I have to make them straight and fine. So I put them in the this guy here, and then I stretch them. And then I, oops, not good enough. So, see if this hold. See now, when I stretch them like this, the thread are kind of straight. So, and then. How long they have to be. And this one is too short. So, but we need to make a lot of those. That we will. So. Now I made this one so long that I cannot. This is long enough. Thank you. And then it's just to make a lot of those. Nice straight ones. Just enough so it don't break, but enough so it gets straight. A little out the way. Ah. I have been in the forest today with my granddaughter. That was nice. The forest is really nice and light green. It's such a nice time of the year. Spring colors so beautiful. day. So and that roll is empty. That away. This is kind of factory work. And this is too short. Assembly line. Henry Ford would have loved this. I think we put one on the floor. I think I will hear what the guys on Twitter have to say today. Twitter is the podcast I listen to normally, but unfortunately I send at the same time as they are doing it. See what they up to. And the podcast is live.twit.tv.
Box, this will work with your Android device. It's simply a USB device, so I can take any one of these plugs that I need.
Take it easy.
My Windows laptop, or I can use it with this cord so that I can plug it into my USB L equipped Android device. Once I've got that connected, I can play pretty much any file format that I want. This will support MP3, AAC, FLAC, PCM, Apple and Windows lossless, and all streaming audio and video formats. And because it has an onboard DAC that's separate
from I don't know what that is.
Inside your phone today. Your laptop, you're not going to get that hump. Because it has an USB, it you can do signal processing inside the device so that you can get really, really nice audio. Get rid of all those artifacts. And because it's powered over the USB bus,
there's some different schedule today than it used to be.
Standard iPhone connector. so that every episode is automatically downloaded into your device of choice. Also, please follow me on Twitter.com/PadreSJ. That's @PadreSJ. If you follow me, you'll find out what I do for every episode. I always announce it ahead of time. You'll be able to suggest products that you want on future episodes and before you buy. And you'll also see what
there was one more. Short. This is not. I even think I need some more thread. Even I have two or six rows yet, but I have to get some spray glue tomorrow so I can get some more thread in the same process. I have I didn't get the video up of yesterday, and I haven't gotten the video up from the day before. I simply haven't had time. And video from 3 days ago took something like 36 hours or something like that to get finished, but the one from yesterday was quick. Who?
But it used to be single, it used to be old. Remember? I, yes, oh, I do remember that.
It's not the ordinary program they have today. I don't know what's the matter. I think it's a rerun of it's a rerun of Android Today or something. That's normally not now, but today it is. It is a podcast that I can recommend if you are tech interested, and they are sending live all the time, and you can download their shows at this I'm seeing on listening to on live.twit.tv. Reruns right now, so I don't know why that is. There must have been a change in plans somehow, but guess that happens everywhere. Shows advertisement, but they only have two or three advertisements doing an hour of show, so but somehow they have to get paid what they do, so otherwise, it's free for everyone to download and see and whatever. Take this one. Maybe I should make some new coffee. I think it's many hours old. It's gonna. Thank you. is only a small roll. There was a little rest on it. We can use that right away. We have one more in here. It's hot under all this light.
But I might not even if there's great Wi-Fi coverage that's surrounding me and it's good enough. I mean, go right now.
pick up a string. Wonderful. I think it will start to rain tonight, sooner or later. It's kind of dripping now. It's a good time. That's spring. A little workout, kind of. Come on. When I have emptied this room, we'll start to make bumps.
Service to use to place a reservation at a restaurant, lots of things. Google Now will hopefully
trimming the end so that it don't get tangled together like it did with the last one. It's much easier that way.
Discontinued and no longer for sale. Limited to Google Play editions and reintroduce them.
So
I didn't have time for dinner tonight, so I need a little salad.
It's
And One on the floor!
Thank you.
Great.
Should I get
Have a little piece to tighten the arm again.
It's practically a Lawrence Welk.
Take a smaller players.
We had a couple of really good reasons.
Color.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. All right. Sorry. I got to retweet real quickly Lisa's post here.
And where is that?
Lisa's at home doing social media. I should retweet it. She might. Get your free Hillary Clinton bumper sticker.
Smaller, you can see. Oops. Yeah.
This might do.
It's better when you get close to something.
Yeah, I had to because I
someone. I need something to do that. Thinking that we could cycle. Unravel later.
they're trying so hard to be Facebook that they're alienating their most loyal users.
Right.
And what they're doing with that, those initiatives, is going after the less loyal people. And so they've got increasingly sort of novice, not really that committed to the platform kind of audience, right? Well, that's true. I mean, if you look at their numbers, their users actually went up, their mobile users, which was stagnant. Twitter is strongly motivated to maintain that growth. And that's one of the things that's kept Twitter from booting spammers, trolls, other undesirables for Twitter, is that they can't afford not to have that growth. But the spammers and trolls are yet another thing that's driving away the committed users. Right? How many reports have you seen of major celebrities, usually women, who basically say, I quit Twitter, I can't handle the vitriol anymore, I can't handle the trolls. For every one of those famous people, there's probably 1,000 people. Fair.
19.
Apple's denying
19.
Because I feel like Google was founded by two smart guys who were cognizant. That's why their R&D budget is billions.
But see, I think you have a really good point. Look at what they've done well. I mean, it goes all the way back to the beginning to the certain tons of data. They've done really well at that. You look at my brain just went. You look at what they did, like things
Android
like
was
YouTube. Well, Android's like the third iteration. If you look at what they're doing now with things like the Google Now integration.
Yeah.
So just doing more integration from apps to Google Now.
Google as an ISP facilitates that, both terrestrial and mobile, because they've got Google Fi now. They have Google Gigabit in some cities.
Ads is the second wave, right? So you've got the browser, right?
Yeah.
Search engines first, then ads. Now Android.
Yeah.
And if you look at it, I think it's somewhere in the rundown.
Chrome,
right?
same thing. They want to own
Chrome end to end.
They can gather data from all of that.
It's the best data gathering points.
But
right?
It's data on you. And you see there's pushback now from society. In fact, somebody in the chat room is saying that it's coming to an end, says RF 2020. Privacy by design is becoming necessary. And isn't that antithetical?
Just a moment.
I feel like I'm getting my money's worth out of Google. In other words, I don't know what Google knows about me, right? It's not like I'm going to see more ads. I already see ads on every surface. It's a Philip K. Dick universe already.
Yeah.
So if they're more targeted, that's better as far as I'm concerned. At least I won't see ads for.
But are they better targeted?
No, they're not. That's why I want to give more information. I want to help you, Google. I want your ads to be better targeted.
Well, that's why this Google Now thing, I think, is so important.
I love
what they're doing, right? So Google, they want Google Now to become your interface. This is the interface to my world. This is the place where I spend my first minute of the day or that minute where I just want to know what's going on. They want to take your eyeballs and dump them into Google Now. And the way that they're doing that is making it more relevant by pulling this information from the app.
Google Now tells me when a bill is going to be due.
Yeah.
Like tomorrow, your PG&E bill is due.
That's useful.
The reason we're so excited about Google Now is it's the one rare example where contextual information actually works. You know, you look at, I saw ads on, I think it was YouTube today, was in another language. I didn't even recognize the language. How do they not know that I'm speaking whatever that language is?
Right?
Wow, look at this Spotify.
All kinds of stuff. 70 relations.
What is that? So this is new integration.
They added all this 70.
What is that? One you forgot to know.
Show. And is this something you're interested in following?
Oh yeah, so your sports stocks places, this is where you, this is much like Cortana on Windows Phone, where when you first set up Cortana, the speech recognition in Windows Phone, you tell her your interests, what you want to know about. The disadvantage Microsoft has is unless you're using Bing all the time and you're really in the Microsoft ecosystem, they're not going to know as much about you. It's interesting, it's becoming a Microsoft versus Google, right?
Or who are you more plugged into?
So, receive now cards from your downloaded apps? Yes. Also, I can't turn this on. Considering receiving now cards from Waze? Yes. So, I haven't yet, it hasn't yet populated this individual app, so I haven't turned that on. Alright, thank you. So, it is in there. It is in there.
They're starting to surface cards in Google Now where if you're driving and it knows you're driving, it will tell you, oh, so, these are the gas stations that are on your route.
Say, put your phone away, you
That's what I should say. The parking one, I think, has been out a little bit, but I'm getting that.
I love that. Yeah. I love that. Parking. It says you parked, and here's where you parked. Yeah.
So I get to
talk about where you parked.
Parking locations. My son has a lot of orders, too. So I get into place cards and next to mine.
He's playing on your Steam account.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the
it's
problem.
Exactly.
I have the same problem.
Yeah.
But you know, I like it because it makes me look like a better gamer than
it
I am.
It does, doesn't it? Yeah.
I got thousands of points or whatever achievements.
Yeah.
Man, you're good at TF2.
Yes, I am pretty good.
Yes, I am. I'm almost as good as a 12-year-old boy. Yeah, look at this app quite a bit, actually. So, that's cool.
That's cool. Again, that's the big data, right? I mean, that's the data analysis that they can do. They're plugging into anything and everything to get
track of this event. I get a lot of event in my email. So you can see what you have stories to read. You know what? This is pretty amazing. The next thing is to put this, I don't know, it's a sort of head-mounted display.
That's the problem with Google Now. It's never right there. Unless you have a Chromebook. Now it's on the Chromebook when you open the Chromebook. There it is. But yeah, you have to always have to remember to go find it. And that's just not how this should work.
If you use the Google Launcher on Android, you swipe left from the home page, and there's your right card. So maybe that's one of the ways to do it.
It's such a hassle.
Radio, right, that was playing old-time radio shows, Lawrence Welk, and out of an old-time radio, but it was over the internet from the Raspberry Pi, so let's see what he's got here. Aaron's Arcade, but first a word from Braintree. If you're a mobile developer, you must know about Braintree. If you're a mobile developer, then you need to know about Braintree. Braintree is a payments API. Go to BraintreePayments.com, you can find out all about it. That makes it very easy for you. Well, let's say you've got a mobile app and you want to accept your payments. Would you like to accept, I don't know, Bitcoin? Sure, no problem. Apple Pay, of course. PayPal? Yeah. Credit cards of any kind? Yes. Venmo? You know about that? That's awesome. They accept it all. And it's with a couple of lines of code. That's what I love about this. The payments API is used by so many great companies. They're used by Uber and Lyft. You know it must be good if Uber and Lyft use it, and Airbnb, and Living Social. GitHub started when they first started taking payments with Braintree, and Braintree's growing with them. They can start from one transaction a day to millions a day. They grow. stuff up. This is pretty cool. Unrelated to GitHub. Airbnb, hotels tonight, travel industry, all of it. BraintreePayments.com/twig. I want you to check it out if you want to take payments. And by the way, fast payouts. And great support.
This one.
Yeah.
10. 12. 14. 16. 18. 19.
Their for the earthquake situation in Nepal, they're going to donate every single bit of money that's donated to
Yep. We lost one.
First.
working. I'm super glued to hold it all together.
Out to all their employees, like make sure you know you're not going to the thing
We know what that did. Oh, I know one thing it did. You can have more than one watch. I don't know exactly what the use case is, but
it's called the Leo-Laporte feature.
Yeah. Right. Do you want more than one? I guess maybe this video will explain.
Well, now Android Wear is supposedly not going to be just for watches, right?
Ah.
It's the wearable bummer.
So I can have Android Wear in my glass and my watch.
And your
that's
smart underwear and your like whatever.
That's what this is. What is he talking about?
Senses 7.3 get to work.
That's right.
This is worthy of a Microsoft
I was just gonna say.
Welcome to the 7.3 of Google Play Services.
So
Wow. That was just...
Some Google API, we have created Microsoft replacements for those APIs. You know,
Is any of this dry? Yes. So we are able to make one. These we can make 30. Two of these rows, because we have two and a little more here. There was a rest on a little leftover on a row, so.
I erased Secret from all my platforms months ago, but it was, for a while, a very addictive thing, especially because everybody in Silicon Valley was posting anonymous posts. Only people in Silicon Valley. Pretty much only people in Silicon Valley. Anonymous posts. Secret does not, this is the, David Bidow, who was the founder, after a lot of thought and consultation with our board, I decided to shut down Secret. Secret does not represent the vision I had when starting
wasn't the fox, the secret icon was a fox. So there's, yeah, there's the sad fox. Wandering off to the sunset. Wow. It's really, when you see the app economy, it is just, we talked about the business cycle being 10 years and less, it's 10 months and less now. You look at apps just on the go, right? Boom.
Yeah.
All right, I think we could do some picks, but you know, I think we should start with Aaron's arcade. Cabinet. This is really, really cool. You posted, you put up a Google slideshow, or what do they call it?
I did that for you guys, so you guys could show some of the pictures.
Uh-huh.
I
want
to
learn
how to do that. I'm going to actually give this presentation. 6th of May in Venetia, for one of our big workshops. Right. So the nice thing about this is it's almost square, and you can play the early consoles, right, which were done on 4.3 TV screens, and you can play the old arcade games. They both work.
Are you running MAME? Are you running an emulator?
So there's a project, and I believe Brian used this for when he did the SNES Raspberry Pi. He did it. It's called Retro Pi. It emulates just about anything. If I had left all the emulators up here, you would have seen that.
Asked me because you're Megan Maroney, who hosts Tech News Tonight, and I met today with me.
So? And we have...
I have, I need about 100 rolls. Again, reached midnight in our little country, so I will I thought there was something. At least I don't remember what it was, so, but I will thank you for watching and hope I'll see you again. We'll be on the same time tomorrow, so good night.